एक संविधान किसी देश में उसकी एवरेज आयु 17 साल मात्र है। हम लोग 72 साल तक आए हैं यहाँ तक। लर्न अर्न एंड रिटर्न, रिटर्न टू द सोसाइटी टू विच यू बिलोंग। इट इज टू ब्रिंग अवेयरनेस ऑन द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड पे आवर रिस्पेक्ट टू द फादर ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डॉक्टर बी आर अम्बेडकर। फ्रेंड्स, वी अडॉप्टेड ए कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एज ए ब्लू प्रिंट फॉर एसोसिएटेड लिविंग। एज बाबा साहब सेज, डेमोक्रेसी इज जस्ट नॉट ए फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट बट ए फॉर्म ऑफ एसोसिएटेड लिविंग। वी लिव टूगेदर, वी लर्न हाउ टू लिव टूगेदर, रिस्पेक्ट इच अदर, सो इट इज ए काइंड ऑफ एसोसिएटेड लिविंग। With the adoption of the Constitution on 26 November 1949, we the people of India became a citizen from a subject we were there under the British Empire. Many of the structural injustices like caste, religion, race, sex, place of work, everything dissipated after we adopted the constitutions. Women, lower caste, minorities, all were involved in this scheme of citizenship. The new constitution was prepared by a group of 296 constitutional members of Constitution Assembly who took almost 166 days spread over 3 years, 3 long years. Exactly 2 years, 11 months, 18 days before it was adopted on 26 November 1949. It took another 2 months on 26 January 1950 when we implemented this constitution. Today it's almost 27 long years that has elapsed. It is by and large, I feel, the rule of constitution has been by and large very fair. It has been very fair, at least its conscience is endowed with humane ideas and very compassionate to the weaker sections, minorities. But today we need to evaluate, and what Baba Saab said long back, 3 warnings he gave. The first one was, Indian should not be content with the political democracy as the inequality and hierarchy were still embedded in the Indian society. If we continue to deny it for long, we will do it so only by putting our political democracy at peril. This was the first warning Dr. Ambedkar gave to us. The second is, bhakti in religion may not be road to the salvation, maybe road to salvation of a soul, but in politics, bhakti or hero worship is a sure road to degradation and eventual dictatorship. The third one was, he never approved of a kind of a protest like civil disobedience, non-cooperation or satyagraha. So, 70 years after, how we have endured as a republic, how the constitution has helped to help us, the citizen of India, to enjoy the freedom of, to enjoy the fruits of freedom. There is a professor from University of Chicago School of Law, Tom Ginsburg. He studied constitutions of almost 200 countries spread over a period of 1789 to 2005. And the result is very disappointing. Almost he has studied 935 constitutions in different constituencies. And he says, the average age of a constituency is only 17 years. Ek samvidhan kisi desh mein uski average ayu 17 saal matter hai. Hum log 72 saal tak aaye hain yahan tak. Countries like France, they had 14 constitution up till now. Our neighbor part, they have three constitutions, one after another. So if you correlate with this 17 years and 72 years, good. But then we have to think of that. Friends, we all pray and wish for the vibrancy and the endurance of our constitution in the years ahead. And with this word, I like to welcome all the dignitaries here present here. And to begin with, I warmly welcome Honorable Mr. Justice Sandeep Kumar, the Judge Patna High Court. Only day before yesterday, I reached him with my request to grace this occasion as a chief guest. And very warmly, he accepted it. Thank you so much, sir. Justice Sandeep Kumar hails from a place which is also the first Republic of India, Lakshmi and Vaishali. He did his law from CLC, Campus Law Center, Delhi, and graduation from the Delhi University. His very democratic approach to justice, I have seen it because I have been with him for almost two decades. We have been together at various places and we have encountered many a times. So thank you, sir, for accepting my request to grace the interview. Thank you so much. I warmly, wholeheartedly welcome Dr. K. Chandru, Justice K. Chandru. I had a very brief encounter when I approached him long back in the previous week. Just one phone call, sir. And he said, yes, I am coming. Thank you so much, sir. After he devoted this at Patna High Court, had a very brief meeting. And so nice of him. He brought a bundle of books for my son, who is a law doing a graduate in National Law School, Bangalore. And said, it is for your son. This shows the personality of man. We never met each other. And he shared me a blueprint of a book which is yet to be published and said, you give me your reaction to this, your appreciation of this blueprint. Thank you, sir, for warmly accepting. Whole Patna and everywhere, people are talking about me. See, on his arrival, this Bhim, Jai Bhim film, that there is another man who hasn't forgotten. And he has connection with this place, Patna. He says when he was an advocate and taking up that Sangani case as a lawyer, and the judge was Mr. P.S. Mishra, who hails from Patna. And when I met him, his first desire was, can you get me connected to Mr. P.S. Mishra family? See, the man, almost, the case was reported in 93 years, I'm correct, sir? And now it is 21, almost 27, 20 years has gap. But he still remembers that this is sir, and a professional lawyer before donning the robe of a judge. He has written number of books. Another touching thing what he shared with me. He is a votary of law, is a weapon to redress the grievances of citizenry. He believes in the importance of literacy as an ultimate liberation. Always says, and that is what Ambedkar was very near to. What did he say? Three words: educate, agitate, and
agitate.
Sir,
agitate.
Organize. EAO. This is how I remember. And to that I end the very famous quote from the Indira Nooyi. Pay back to society. How she says, learn, earn, and return. Return to the society to which you belong. Take care of your society. Learn, earn, and then return. Go back to your society. Help the poor. Help the needy. The people who have been discriminated. Help them. Beautiful words. Thank you so much, sir. And I warmly welcome Patna. She has been often coming to Patna. Mrs. Arfa Khanam. Renowned journalist. Having experience of almost 2 decades. I'm a correct man. And she has worked for Pioneer. She worked for NDTV. And presently she is a very senior editor of The Wire. She has been roaming around the country length and breadth. Last election she was in Bihar also. And I had a very brief encounter, very little, for about 5 minutes. But I could feel the vibe in her. The concern from the democracy, for the constitutions, for the marginalized people, from the people, discriminated people. I can feel that vibe coming up from Mrs. Khanam. She also said, just a phone call last week when she was probably planning a tour to Chhattisgarh only. She finished the previous evening and she came rushing to it was very difficult, I know, I'm sorry. But she has to take a very early morning flight to come to. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you very, very much. Sorry. And on the dais is my colleague, A.K. Yadav. He knows, he doesn't require any introduction because very often we have been together and addressing such functions in various fora. Additional DG, 96th batch IPS officer, additional DG, police, looking after the weaker sections, cases against weaker sections. He has been a great, great Democrat and great police officer when it comes to giving justice or going for a professional policing, professional investigations. I always salute his determinations. I always salute his determinations. Thank you, A.K. Yadav, for always being with me. Thanks so much. Mr. I warmly welcome one of the speaker who is not in the dais, Mr. Ajit Singh. He is the president of Bihar Judicial Services Association and presently postures as the ADJ Kishanganj. He is like a brother to me, very often been contacted at a various forum, and only I requested him day before yesterday to come for these functions. He readily agreed to it. Thank you, Mr. Ajit ji. Thank you so much. Thank you. And sitting beside him is Shri Anil Ramji, additional district judge, Nawada. Thank you, Ajit ji. Yeah, Anil, you always grace such occasions. Thank you so much for accepting my invitations. Sitting on the dais is, I introduced Sister Sudha Varghese. I said, when I was CTS in Patna long back in 1996, we had an encounter on an issue of a rape of a girl. She was very furious. She came along with hordes of women. I appreciated that gesture and this determination to, you know, be associated with a girl who had been abused. Since then, we are, you know, on that wavelength. Thank you, sister. In fact, I didn't extend her formal even greetings, you know, and invitation also. I just saw her. She was here and I invited her. She accepted. Thank you so much, sister. She's a Padma Sri Awardee. Recently, I think the previous week, she won another 25 lakhs from that Kaun Banega Crorepati. 25 lakhs. She runs. She has from, see that this frail lady, all coming from far off Kerala. And she has given her all her life for the welfare of the wretched of the Bihar populace, that the Mujahars. Almost 40 long years, she has been serving. She is running the Pramarsh Kendra and special schools and all. Thank you, sister, so much. And on the other corner is Father Peter. Everyone, I think, Patna knows, who have a difficulty in getting admission to a school, and a school like St. Xavier and St. Michael's. Peter, you know, he served as headmaster of that St. Michael, the prestigious St. Michael's school, for 13 long years, sir. Am I correct? 13 साल तक वो प्रिंसिपल प्राचार्य रहे और ये ट्रिमेंडस मैन ऑफ एनर्जी ऑलवेज यू सी प्लेइंग विद द किड्स वो एक बच्चा जन जानते हैं द स्टूडेंट दे फील सो कंफर्टेबल विद हिम थैंक यू फादर थैंक यू सो मच एंड जस्ट टू वाइंड अप फ्रेंड्स लेट अस लर्न फ्रॉम वॉट एवर इज गिवन फ्रॉम दिस प्लेटफॉर्म. It is very, very important occasion for her. And once again, wish you everyone a happy Constitution Day. Thank you so much.